Attention, please. Attention, please. Boys, girls, welcome to the audition of Marilyn the Musical. As you all know, our high school will produce Marilyn the Musical. The producer of the show is Miss Eileen, our principal.
Good afternoon, everyone.
As for the director, will be Mr. Derek, the well-known director and choreographer. Music will be composed by Mr. Tom, our art teacher. And our lovely English teacher, Miss Julia, will be the script writer. To start the audition, we're going to choose the dancers for the show, boys and girls. The main cast will be decided by Miss Eileen and her team. I know you all are very excited, especially on who will play the main role as Marilyn Monroe. Okay, boys, girls, let's start.
Okay, I'm eliminating down now. When I call your name, please come down and form a line. Ivy, Jessica, Christy, Bella, Grace, Stella, Luna, Joanne, Karen, Lisa, Alexa, Mandy, Elisa, and Elia. That's all, guys. And the other girls, thank you for coming. And for the boys, see you at the studio. Girls, please fill the stage and make as much room as possible. I wanna see you do your own thing, so move as you like.
It isn't over. I can't imagine what you want.
You and you stand at the back, and the others step forward, please. And thank you very much. See you at the studio. And you must be Ivy.
Yes, sir.
And you?
Karen.
Okay, that's it for now. Yes, Aileen.
I know that you've worked really hard for this audition, but how is the result? Did you get the actress to play Marlin?
Yes, but there are two girls, and I'm still not sure which one is better.
Is that so? Who are they?
We have Ivy from 11th grade and Karen from 10th grade. And from these two candidates, I think Ivy is far much better than Karen.
I think they both great. But we can't make a rush decision.
It's not rushing, but in my humble opinion, as an art teacher, I believe Ivy will do such a good job as Marilyn Monroe.
As a director, I still can't make decision right now. I need to see both of them once again. And I suggest we make a callback session.
That's a great idea. Let's have a callback. Tom? Please make a beautiful song for Marilyn's role, and Julia, you know what to do with the script, right?
I will not disappoint you, ma'am. I'm going to write perfect lyrics and dialogue for Marilyn's role.
Wow, I'm so excited. I will compose beautiful songs for Marilyn. Can't wait.
Yeah, my head is already full of ideas for the lyrics.
We're gonna make one hell of a show, Julia.
Just like in Broadway.
Okay, let's do it.
Musical production is about to begin. That's the way of a high school tradition. We go to every rear of all the studio chiefs, and you can bet your ass we've kissed her. Even the birds in the top of the hills know the secret to our success. It's those magical words that pay the bills. Yes, 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 and yes.
Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Good morning, Mr. Tom.
Good morning,
Mr. Tom.
Gentlemen, take a memo. Today the streets are all aglow with roses for our Miss Monroe. The things those vermin must know is what she puts us through. She makes directors wait all day, 1 night per hour is all she'll say. Till she thinks we're gonna pay, she's a talking to. Tomatoes like her must be put in their place. If she don't shape up, soon she'll soon be walking. Cause the buck starts with me.
Yes, you're right, we agree.
Don't say yes until I'm finished talking.
And while you got me on roll, let's find roll for you and all. Tell Julia her square is right, a little lower, to the right. I think that Brando is miscast. The television just won't last. But I'm the king of musical.
Oh, well,
that
feels
good. We squeeze it back to the dumb blonde to her demands. I'm Aerosmith. Somebody her act, but I'm not calm. You better fall in line. You're too soon, so not so good. I'll keep you in a bathing suit. When you stop bringing in mood, we'll go back to the vibe.
Tomatoes like you, they all wither and die. My powers, though, will never be diminished. So don't bring me to my boiling point. You're just a broad eye on the joint. I'm in control, you're just a face. So allow me to cut to the chase. I'll make another movie star. Can someone light my damn cigar? And then say yes, cause yes, man, I'm finished. Yes!
start getting
it. I'm going to do the warm-up first, okay?
Hi, I'm Karen. I'm from the 10th grade.
Oh, look who's here. It's Karen from the 10th grade.
Ooh, the new rising star of St. Ursula. Oh, no, I'm not the new rising star. I'm not that good.
Well, you must be really good, Karen, because no one has ever been compared with Ify before.
How could anyone? She's the goddess of performing arts.
Wow, really?
Well, I'm not surprised. She's been taking ballet, vocal, and acting lessons since before she could even say,
Mama, Mama.
Come on, guys. Enough about me. How about you, Karen? I'm sure you've performed in many shows, right?
Oh, well, actually, I've performed once in a Christmas play before, when I was in the kindergarten.
Was it a big part?
Yeah, a pretty big part actually. I was on the entire show, never left the stage.
Oh, I know, guys. She's the star of the show. Were you Maria?
No. I was the tree.
Tree. I'm sorry. It's good to be a tree. I've never got to be one. Can you imagine what it's like to be a tree?
Well, it must be really difficult.
That's not true. That's a bush.
An oak tree. Hearing the ear.
Linda!
Sir, sir, I'm here.
Okay, everybody ready? Who's going to go first?
Ify first. Let's be bad. Ify, stand by. And dancers too.
If you say something is trouble, well, that's the thing I wanna do. Do it till we're black and blue, let's be bad. Guns and gangs is super fun. A Capone is a body of mine. This is my big show Valentine, let's be bad. If spirits are sagging, if feet are dragging, fall off the wagon, the piano hums and the bass and drums. I'll be dancing when the hookah comes. Don't care if you die now. Most folks make my thing up. Mount the ice, I'm liking hot. Let's be bad. Here's Morris, so make you better. Let me wet, it's got a ladder. When I'm bad, I'm even better. Let's be bad. See, bop, up propriety. No polite society. Give me no variety. Let's be bad. Bring on the the prices, I'll add the right spices. When I send out face, see me in the face. Only and my husband, I'll embrace. I can see the use of waiting. Your lips are intoxicating. Do my hips in some translating. Let's be back. If I drown in pathogen, no one about my next of kin. They might grieve on my jumping. Let's be back. Who wants praise and only dramas? Gushman is the cat pajamas. I'm the queen of the red high mamas. Let's be back. It's cooking gym man. It's cooking gym man. Just stick with me, man. Every choice is you. With my right heart, you. And just like you, this one's safe to look. It's the key for my mission. Hit the gas in my mission. We're here to things I'm wishing. You won't know for opposition. Last girl here, big bra ambition. Let's be.
Great, great, good job. How is it, Mrs. Eileen? Isn't she great? See, I told you she's perfect to play Marilyn.
Dancers, take five.
Ivy, perfect for the role. I admit it. You are right on the money this time, Tom. But we still have another girl, don't we? Well, let's have a short break and then we are going to see the other girl. What's her name again?
Karen.
Oh, yeah, right, Karen.
Wow, she really is good.
Nah, I don't think so.
Oh, really? How could she not be good? She's the star of all the school's production, right?
Well, that's the fact.
part.
But you should know how she got those parts.
Mm-hmm. She worked really hard, ass to the ground.
Well, something to do with the ass, but another kind of...
What do you mean?
She licks the asses of every teacher that can make her get what she wants.
Seriously? Of course, darling. Especially Mr. Tom. Yeah.
I heard that every Sunday, Mr. Tom goes to Ivy's place and can have dinner with her parents.
Who knows what they talk about? But guys, Ivy looks kind of nice.
Oh, come on. She's like the devil. She'll do anything to get what she wants.
And right now, she wants the part.
Oh, then she could have it. I'm out.
No! Remember, this is the devil's work, Karen. Don't fall into her trap. Don't be intimidated. Be strong. Dare to challenge that she, devil herself.
You're good, Karen. Better than Ivy. You'll be Marilyn.
Karen, are you ready? We're going to start.
Good luck, Karen. You can do this.
Okay, and 5, 6, 7, 8.
In this factory, dreams can come true. Are you ready to make someone new? You're the team that is deep speed to do. You're 20th century Fox Mambo.
Cut! Forgetting the lyrics is unacceptable at this stage even. I'll give you 1 minute to work it out. Linda! Please do something about it.
Okay, sir. Karen, here. Read it again. Memorize it.
I'm sorry. I know the lyrics. I was just nervous. People are laughing at me.
So? You have to be more focused. It's all in your mind. People are not laughing at you. Now, take a deep breath. And relax. You can do it.
Linda!
She's ready!
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure!
Okay then. Others, please be quiet. We are auditioning, okay?
In this factory, dreams can come true. Are you ready to make someone new? You're the team that must teach me to do. You're 20th century Fox Mambo.
What was the problem again?
Sorry, I was...
No excuses. If you want to be on stage, you do nothing else but perform. So no excuses, darling.
I'm sorry, I guess I can't do it.
Please, stop saying it, okay?
But can I just stand back and watch the others first?
No, Karen. Try to concentrate more.
Karen.
Yes, sir?
If you can do it, then you can do it. If you can't, so what? You want to try it or not?
Okay, sir, I want.
Okay. And 5, 6, 7, 8.
In this factory, dreams can come true. Are you ready to make someone new? You're the team that must teach me to do. You're 20th century Fox Mambo. Done the homework and now pass the test. I'll do whatever my teacher suggests. I can do it clothed or undressed. You're 20th century Fox Mambo. Make it up, shake it up. Let the fantasies begin. Here's the dough. So get cast, stage the path. Make the light just race for sin. Oh, let's go. Take a gamble, it's safe to bet. Mr. Sanity ain't seen nothing yet. When we're finished, you'll never forget. You're 20th century Fox.
Thank you.
need action. Now I'm blonde, but I ain't so dumb. Hollywood will be under my thumb. I'll chase partners until I become.
Are you?
Hi, I'm Olivia.
Do you know who I am?
Of course, you're Ivy. Everybody knows you. I love to copy your fashion, and sometimes I take pictures of you from far. I wish I could.
Okay, stop. So, what are you doing here?
Having lunch.
I mean. What are you still doing here?
So, Ivy, what do you think? Does Karen have a chance to take Marilyn's role?
Karen? Karen who?
Alexa, have you lost your mind? Of course not.
Ivy usually gets the role. Everyone in the audition room knows how sucks Karen was. Am I right, guys?
Yes! Come on. Even blind people can see that Ivy is so much better than Karen. No wonder, of course, Ivy is the it girl in the school.
Well, you guys see it for yourselves. She was shaking like jello. She was still the same.
I'm not surprised if she pee-pee in her pants.
That's why all the smell big there.
I can imagine.
But I think... Mr. Tom is really on your side, Ivy.
Yeah, my mom hired Mr. Tom to give me private class at my house just for this audition.
Wow! How much did you pay him?
A lot.
Well, surely Mr. Tom doesn't want that new girl to be chosen.
But what about Derek? He seems to be nice to her, ain't he?
Derek is a great director. Of course, he can see who is the professional and who is the amateur one. Am I right, guys?
Yeah, that's true. But what about Mrs. Eileen?
Listen, my parents already donated a lot of money for this school, including the new basketball court. So, if they want the new girl to be chosen, they really have to think about it again. Are they willing to give up my parents' donations?
Yeah, you're so damn right.
You know what? I heard Karen got into the school through a scholarship program. Her parents can't afford our school, of course.
Aww. So she's poor.
She'll never be Marilyn. The role is mine.
Who's the real Marilyn?
Ivy!
But Marilyn Starr is a poor girl, ain't she? So...
You want Marilyn? I'll give you Marilyn.
When you are born, sex appeal in a forest called Hollywood. You'll find more wolves at your back door than that little Red Riding Hood. Now she and a little old grandma, we have learned from the man I dated. That a wolf can be quite a devotee once he's the master kitten.
Mm-hmm.
should teach in school, when the girl gets curvy and the boys all drool. If math and science just ain't your style, just give that teacher a wink and a smile. For a passing grade, you don't have to wait, and you can thank him later when you graduate. Cause I never met a woman who didn't love to howl. No, I never met a man who wasn't on the prowl. If a nice diploma you want to get, wanna make that students back. Yeah, I never met a wolf who didn't love to howl. A wealthy wolf likes to buy his toys, but he really is just one of the boys. If you've got something for which he's craving, it sure is good that he's been saving. Be a fan, give a chick a pat, but get his autograph on the cashier's check. Yeah, I never met a wolf who didn't love to howl. Surely make a nice work call. Yeah, I never met a woman who didn't love to howl. Yeah, I never met a woman who didn't.
I'm so sorry I'm late. There was a briefing after rehearsal.
It's okay, babe. How's your rehearsal today?
Not so good, I guess. Can I order drinks first? I'm so thirsty. Have you ordered yet? Oh, what did you order? Oh, wow. I need to go to the toilet. With the toilet left. All right.
Karen, what happened? Slow down. What's wrong, babe? You only act like this when you try to cover your feeling about something. Tell me, what's going on?
Yeah, I'm upset about the callback audition today. My performance was bad. I guess I'm just not cut out for Maryland.
Wait, what? Why? You can sing, you can dance, you can act.
Yes, I know, but it's not enough. I have to be the best to be Maryland, and I'm definitely not.
Babe, you got a callback from hundreds of students. That mean? You can be the one.
But I'm not as good as Ivy. She's sensational. I can't be like her. She's really good. I mean, really, really, really good.
Please, don't make that solemn face. But, wait. I love you even more when you put that face on.
Not funny, Dave.
But why are you smiling?
Because you're not funny. You are very boring and I'm very hungry.
That's my girl. Prakash!
Who's Prakash?
My cousin. He's a trainee here. We'll have 2 chicken tandoori. It's the best in town. Thank you.
Babe, can I ask you something?
Sure.
Why do you believe in me, Dave?
Because you're no bullshit. And I'm no bullshit. I'm not saying this because I love you. But because I know you can do it. Because your friends know you can do it. And I know you want to do it. And you need to do it.
Dave.
What?
You're kind of funny when you talk like that.
Seriously, Karen. Are you going to do it?
Yes, of course.
Must always point ahead. Yesterday's fine. Today has come and gone. The secret of tomorrow's coming fast. Which bedtime story shall I sing to you when we turn out the light? One of eternity or one of just a thousand and one night? Is there a mystic with the answers from above? Is there a goddess with the hourglass of love? So many questions reeling all around my heart. If it's the end or just the start, will I shower you with riches every year the night we met? Will you take my heart or melt it like it's gold? Will our love go on forever, or is this all that we get? Is the night the last or just the future hold? Last time of the life, just 1,001 nights.
Darling, you seem to think that I'm the only one who has to choose, that you are in control and get to set the rules of ignorance. The bedtime story that I'll sing to you when we turn on the lights. Maybe eternity, or maybe just 1,001 nights. There is no mystic with the answers from above. You know the secrets from the way to keep my love. There are 1,000 more ways to win my heart. Believe this wrong, but for a start, you can shower me with riches every year the night we met. I may take your heart and melt it like it's gold. Play in someone's perfume garden, and this night's the last you'll get. Play your cards around your future, just my hope. Lifetime won't be light, or just 1,001
appear to have it all.
The tiger just appears to win his danger by their voice.
I surely will obey you when you call.
And will you show me with riches every year that we met?
Will you take my heart and melt it like it's gold? Will our love go on forever? All this is all that we get. Is tonight the last or just the future hold?
Everybody, listen up. After not so long discussion, we have decided that the one who will play the role of Merlin is none other than Ivelyn.
See, it's you. I knew it.
We all knew it, Ivy.
Congratulations.
Thanks, guys.
So hard to have fun.
Yeah. Derek, I have finished editing the new lyrics. National pastime.
Did you make a lot of changes?
Nope, just a few minor corrections.
Great. Ivy, darling, would you please learn this song so we can start the rehearsal in a moment? And Linda, how are we on the dancers?
They're all warmed up and ready to rock and roll.
Great, but first I want to see Ivy sing it solo. Okay, Ivy. Ready?
Oh, I was just so born ready to be Marilyn.
Great. Let's start. And 5, 6, 7, 8.
I just got a date. She just got a date with baseballs. Jolt and Joe, lucky so-and-so. Strum me on my bases.
Cut. No doubt, Ivy. Fabulous singing. But could you please try to be more Marilyn? You sound a bit more like Rihanna. And we are not doing Rihanna's life story.
Yeah, sure, no problem. I just got a date, just got a date. Baseballs, joking.
God! Ivy, I know in the end, Marilyn is a drug addict. But we are not portraying that side of her yet. So can you show me a more honest, simple, Marilyn sensuality.
Okay, so you want that side of her piece of cake.
Let's try one more time.
I just got a date, she just got a date. Baseballs, Jolt and Joe, lucky so-and-so.
Strong. God! What the hell? Take five, guys.
I did good.
What's wrong, Derek? Is it the lyrics?
Lyrics fine. It's Ivy. She just can't nail it.
Maybe she's still nervous. It's not easy, you know, to be Marilyn. And it is her first try.
Yeah, but first try matters. I think she's a bit overconfident. And I have to do something about it.
What?
Appoint Karen as an understudy will be perfect for her and for us.
Have you lost your mind, Derek? You can't do that. It's absurd.
Calm down. What do you think, Eileen?
I have to agree with Tom. Because I don't want people to think that there's a chance of Ivy not playing Marilyn.
And why is that such a big problem?
Because I have told Mrs. Leigh Conroy that Ivy Lynn, her darling daughter, is going to be Marilyn. And she's so happy.
What? Why on earth did you do that?
Because she is the biggest sponsor of the show.
But if I'm not mistaken, I am the director here. I can choose whoever I feel fit to play Marilyn for the sake of the show.
There will be no show if there's no money, Derek. And you choose Ivy because she is good.
Yes, Derek, it's gotta be Ivy. Karen is not gonna make it.
Yeah, Tom is right. Karen is still a newbie on performing on stage. Her skills are not there yet.
Guys, who says that I'm going to replace Ivy with Karen? I just want her to be an understudy.
I think it's just a waste of time and energy.
Oh, you know, Tom, I got a better idea. How about if you become the director?
Okay, Derek. It is decided that Karen is going to be the understudy of Ivy as an effort to push Ivy to be a better Marilyn.
Great. Okay, everybody, listen up. From now on, Karen is going to be the understudy of Ivy. And Karen has to learn all of Marilyn's parts.
Is he crazy or what? I'm so pissed off.
She likes Ivy. It's just an understudy.
Yeah, understudy is so under, you know. You're still the star, right?
No way. Karen will be better than you, baby.
But shouldn't we do something about it? Just in case, you know.
What do you mean?
Come on. Let's start again. Dancers, stand by.
I want to see Karen this time, please.
Me? Now, sir?
Well, you can do it tomorrow, if you like.
Okay, sir, I'll do it.
Okay. And 5, 6, 7, 8.
Just got a date. Baseball's Joe and Joe. So run me around the bases, put me through my faces, and teach me all the things this love is love. Should know. When I was just a little girl, I liked being zany and pretty. But now that I'm giving a sports a whirl, I find I kinda like to get dirty. That's the team movement. And I like the Nazi scene. No girls, I'm mean. Yes, my skill and my passion, I'll elevate the national. I don't care about your
Great! And that's a wrap for today.
I'm sorry, sir. Is it bad? I can do it again if you want.
No, you're okay. For now. And maybe Ivy can learn some points from you too, Karen. Now off, rehearsal.
What? Ivy has to learn from that stupid new girl?
No way! It's like Rihanna has to learn from...
From...
You!
What do you mean?
Come on, you know what I mean?
Oh, please shut up. This is such a bad day for me. It sucks.
I mean, baby.
What, Dave? I think I had to go on rehearsal today. Maybe you were right that I'm as good as Ivy. Maybe I have a chance to be Marilyn.
You're kidding, right?
No, Dave. Today I got to play Marilyn.
So now you're Marilyn?
Oh, well, understudy, but Derek told Ivy to learn some things from me. Yay!
Yeah. How did it happen, babe?
I followed your instructions, sir. When they told me to sing as Marilyn, I said to myself, no bullshit, Karen. You can do it. And I did it.
I'm so proud of you, babe. This will be the best news for mom and dad on Saturday.
Oh my god, Dave, I have rehearsal on Saturday.
What do you mean?
I've got promoted now, Dave. I'm the understudy for Marilyn now. So I have to rehearse all day Saturday.
But it's the only time to meet mom and dad.
I'm free on Sunday.
Karen, my mom and dad are going back to India on Sunday.
What? That soon?
I've already promised them that you will come along and meet them on Saturday.
But I can't miss any rehearsal now, Dave.
It's just only for 1 or 2 hours. Can't you ask for permission?
No, I can't, Dave. You know, understudies have to be on standby 24 hours if necessary.
Don't you think you're overreacting, babe?
Dave, you gotta support me on this, aren't you?
It sure is. But it's just only a matter of 2 hours.
No, I can't, Dave. To be Marilyn is important to me and... I thought it's important to you too.
It sure is. But promise to my mom and dad are also important. Don't you think? Just 2 hours, babe.
Anything can happen in 2 hours, Dave.
You're joking, right?
Does it look like I'm joking?
Ah, Karen, please understand my situation here. I'm not asking much. Just 2 hours. Make up something. Or whatever.
I thought you really support me on this day.
I do.
No, you're not.
I do, but...
But what?
Well, nothing. I just tell my mom and dad that you will be the great Marilyn of all times.
Reflection in the mirror. Why am I doing this to myself? I'm losing my mind on a tiny error. I nearly left the real me on the shelf. No, 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 no. There's nothing wrong with who you are. There's no egos, fake shows, like, just go and leave it alone.
what is wrong, Derek?
It's Ivy. She's not getting anywhere.
What do you mean, not getting anywhere? She hits all the right tunes perfectly, and no slips in her dialogues, right?
Yeah, it's true, Derek.
Yeah, she's okay. But I see that Karen is getting more serious into Marilyn's character.
Yes, so? That's what an understudy is supposed to do, right?
Very right, Tom. Karen is becoming more Marilyn, and Ivy is still Ivy.
So, what exactly do you suggest, Derek?
How about, from now on, we start the rehearsal with Karen as Marilyn?
That's insane! You want to ruin the show?
On the contrary, Tom. This is just what the show needs. Marilyn!
But people already bought tickets to see Ivy. No one wants to see Karen.
What do you think, Eileen?
Well, Derek has a strong point indeed. But if we replace Ivy, I'm sure our main sponsor will not be happy about
it. So there we go. We put Karen to play Marilyn to please the audience, or we put Ivy to please the sponsor. It's your call, Eileen.
How about we try with Ivy and Karen as Marilyn? So for now, we have two main roles, and then we'll choose it after 2 or 3 days.
What? Eileen, please, don't waste our time.
For the sake of the show, Tom, we have to do it.
Karen is not that bad, Tom. Give her a chance.
Whatever.
Let's do it.
Okay, attention please, everybody. There is a major change for the show. Derek, tell them.
From now on, we have two main roles, Karen and Ivy. And we will see after 2 or 3 days who in the end will be Marilyn.
What? You can't do that. Why?
We will choose the best for the show, I assure you.
But my mom...
Eileen will take care of your mom. Now let's start the rehearsal. We don't have much time left. Linda!
Yes, sir. We start with Marilyn and Joe DiMaggio part. Who's going to be Marilyn this time, sir?
We'll go with Karen.
Okay, then. Wardrobe! Oh, the wardrobe is already here. Please put the costume on Karen. Michael? Where's Michael?
Right here.
You'd be Joe DiMaggio. You ready?
Yep.
Dancers, ready in your position. Multimedia, stand by.
Okay, and 5, 6, 7, 8.
Do, do, do.
It's on the paper, 'cause the things I wanna show you can't be written down. Let my lips to the teach.
Turn off the camera, kick your shoes off for this scene. You should be sitting down. Yeah, sitting close enough for reaching.
Turn down the lamp, for the last page has been turned.
When the dawn's breaking through,
we can stop and review
all the last signs you have found. 'Cause history is made at night. So close the books, turn off the light and listen. Let my heart be the teacher. No one here to disapprove as we review the lessons you've been missing. Let the moon be our only light. 'Cause history is made at night. Yes, our history was made at night.
Great. Let's take 5, everybody. Karen, come here.
Karen, you were so good.
Yeah, that was so cool, and I'm so proud of your friend.
Me too.
It was amazing, guys.
It's gone!
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. It was here, but it's not here anymore. It's new. It's a special gift for my boyfriend. Where could it be?
Don't be such a drama queen.
I got a headache already. Please shut up.
It's gone.
Sorry.
My iPhone from Danny.
Maybe you left it somewhere.
You took a selfie before rehearsal, remember?
Yeah, it's the last time I saw it, but it's not here anymore. I'm sure somebody stole it.
Hey, watch your mouth, Bella.
Yes, okay, Bob.
Hey, guys! What's the fuss?
Somebody stole my brand new iPhone 6 from Donnie, sir.
Are you sure it's stolen?
Well, it's out of my bag, sir, and I can't find it anywhere.
Well, I'm sure that nobody has stole it from you, darling.
No.
Okay, everybody, let's sort this out. Bella has just lost her iPhone.
Oh, God.
And to make sure that nobody has stole it, I'd like you all to put your bag right here.
Derek, let me take care of it.
Thank you, Julia.
Guys, I guess I have to check all your bags. Are we okay about this?
Fine.
Is this your iPhone?
No.
It's mine.
No.
How about this one?
No, not that one.
This one?
Yes, that's mine.
That's your bag, right?
You sure?
Yes, yes, yes! That's DB's sticker!
What's DB? Anyway!
Donnie Bella!
Okay, sure. Okay. Karen, is it not yours?
No, but I don't know how it got into my bag. I didn't take it!
Liar!
Okay, Karen, come with me to the principal's room.
What?
Derek, let me borrow her.
Well, do what you have to do. And the rehearsal is finished for today.
I didn't take it.
What a crap! I never make the wrong decision. I'm confident enough to make a good show. I know exactly the right cast, the right music, the right song, the right moment. But maybe there is something else beside that. I wonder.
Okay. Let's be frank now. Alexa, it's you, isn't it?
What? I thought it was you!
No way, it's me.
So, who put it?
Lisa?
I'm not that bitch.
Well, you put it yourself, Bella.
What for?
Who knows? Someone told you to.
No.
Oh my God, I think I fitted it.
O-M-G. She's so brilliant. I just realized that she's the one.
The one what?
Ivy, you're amazing.
You got the best way to get rid of her.
What are you guys talking about?
Wait, it's you, isn't it?
Oh, so you guys think that I'm the one who put the iPhone on Karen's back?
It's not you?
Of course it's not me. I really don't want her to get the part, but I'm not gonna let myself do such things.
If it's not you, who is it then?
Guys, you put the iPhone on Karen's back, right?
Must be one of you. Just spill it out.
You are all mean. In case you forgot, it's in Karen's back. So it's Karen. As simple as that.
We know Karen. She'll never do that.
Well, I heard that she comes from a poor family.
Well, that's no reason to accuse her.
Oh, we're not accusing her. The iPhone in her bag is hard evidence that she stole it.
Yep. Well, I'm sure somebody put it in her bag. Karen is not that poor, you know.
Well, maybe it's you, or maybe you are too coward to put it in your own bag.
Are you crazy? Why would we do things like that?
Why not?
Why not you? You have every reason to do it.
What reason?
You want Ivy to be Marilyn, and you know that Karen is much better.
Oh, are you gonna say that? Are you blind? Ivy's much better than Karen.
Okay.
Just be honest, guys.
No, you be honest.
Yeah, you be honest.
You be honest.
Shake it up, shake it out. Shake it up, shake it out. Ooh, whoa. Shake it up, shake it out. Shake it up, shake it out. Ooh, whoa. And it's hard to dance with the devil on your back. So shake them all. Ooh, whoa.
And I am done with my graceless heart. So now I'm gonna cut it out.
Spread the truth.
I'll dance to the storm. It's always darkest before the
day. Shake it out, shake it out. Shake it out, shake it out. Ooh, whoa. And it's hard to dance with the devil on your back. So shake them all. Ooh, whoa. Shake it out, shake it out. Shake it out, shake it out. Ooh, whoa. Shake it out, shake it out. Shake it out, shake it out.
Karen didn't steal Bella's iPhone. We already know who did it.
And you know it how? Did somebody confess?
CCTV. You know everything that you guys are doing.
So who is it then?
Yeah, yeah, it's us, right?
Olivia? Do you want to tell something to your friend here?
I'm so sorry. I'm the one who did that stupid thing, but I didn't know it would end up like this.
So you took Bella's iPhone. Why?
I heard that Karen's going to replace you. I got panicked, so I had to do something. I am your biggest fan, Ivy.
But you didn't have to do that.
But I don't want Karen to be the Marilyn. I want you, Ivy. You're the best. You're the perfect Marilyn. It has to be you.
Stop it.
I'm so sorry, Ivy.
It's not Ivy I've say started to. It's Karen.
Yeah, because of you, Karen lost her chance to be Marilyn.
Yeah.
Well, it's not exactly true. Derek can still make his decision. Is it Ivy or Karen? And I'll give him time until 1 hour before the show, so you guys will hear it from him then. So come on, let's finish the preparation. Hush, hush.
Derek, can I ask you something?
Sure.
Why is it not me? I want to know, am I that bad?
No. You are a fine singer. You are a good actress. But you're just not Marilyn. As simple as that.
Okay, sir. I get it.
Linda! Where is Karen? Has anybody seen Karen?
Wait a minute, Derek. Hey, Michael, have you seen Karen?
No, I haven't seen Karen.
Oh, come on. Can somebody find Karen now, please?
She's here, sir.
What are you doing here? I've been looking for you everywhere. Stand up.
No, sir. I guess I can't do it.
What's wrong with you?
I'm wrong. I can't think of anything right now.
Why?
It's my boyfriend. He just can't understand me. I can't do this without his support.
Yes, you can, and I know it.
I can't be Marilyn, sir.
But I'm not going anywhere without Marilyn.
I can't be Marilyn, sir. My life is a mess. It's a chaos.
Karen, we are all artists here. If you are in pain, feel it on the stage. Share it to the audience. Because that's what makes a show a memory to everybody. The performers and the audience. I know you can do it. Unless indeed you are nobody and you don't want to be somebody. The truth is that you have the ambition to be a star and I know it. So stop the bullshit. Wipe your tears and go get ready to rock the stage.
Okay.
Now change it to your costume and go get ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, we present you Marilyn the Musical.
They thought they could dispose me. They tried to make me small. I suffered each indignity, but now rise above it all. Yes, the price I paid was all I have, but at last I found release. And if something good could come from bad, the past can rest in peace. Oh, if you see someone's heart in need of a hand, you don't forget me. Or hear a melody cry from some baby bride, you don't forget me. When you sing happy birthday to someone you love, or see diamonds you wish were all free, please say that you won't. I pray that you don't forget me. But forget every man who I ever met, cause they all only live to control. For a kiss they paid a thousand, yet they paid 50 cents for my soul. They took their peace, the price of fame that no one can repay. Ah, but they didn't buy me, but they bought my name. And that is why I pray that when you see someone's hurt in need of a hand, you don't forget me. Or hear a melody cry from some baby grand, you don't forget me. When you sing happy birthday to someone you love, or see diamonds you wish were all free, please say that you won't. I pray that you don't forget me. There are some in this world who have strength on their own, never broken or need a repair. But there are some born to shine who can do it alone, so protect them and take special care.
Great.
Thanks, Ivy.
And I brought something else for you, babe. I'm so proud of you.
Oh, thank you. I'm so happy.
Stay in sorrow, so converted, and this life's the last you'll get. Play your cards.
Musical. The Choirs. The Dancers. Michael and Maria Francisca Meliani as Cafe Singers. Felicia Martina Juantoro, Kevin Putra, and Adrian Julio Nigel as Olivia, Jeff, and Michael. Andrea Natania, Elizabeth Nadia Hale, Renata Dia Prima Hapsari, and Kenan Dio as Karen's Gang. Nadia Emanuela Geraldine, Natia Prilianda, Naura Fakira, Olivia Monique Deborah, and Valen Wijaya as Ivy's Gang. Cindy Grace, Melvin, Ruth Natasha Susanto, Lydia Christy Andamari, and Gregorius Pratama as the production team. Musical performance. And of course, all of this cannot be done without the hard work of the cast and also from the mentors of Eki Dance Company. So now, we will call onto the stage the mentors and those who have supported Smash the Musical. Aiko Seno Sunoto, Connie Novia, and team as costume designer. Multimedia. Sunario as sound arranger. Sugengya and Alim Jamie as lightning arranger. Dimas Lemena as stage manager. Aiko Seno Sunoto and team, represented by Reni Turanga as script writer. Andino Siahaan as vocal coach. As our vocal coach and song arranger. Nanang Hape. Kresna Gede Juliantara as acting coach. Kojek Kodrata. Taka Colleen. Helen Irawati. Yuliani Hopranoto. Ruski Rukmarata. And now, we would like to invite Sister Francesco Marianti OSU to come to this stage and give a token of appreciation to the representatives of Eki Dance Company. Sugeng Yeah as Lightning Arranger. Please come to the stage. Dimas Lemena as stage manager. Andino Siahaan as vocal coach. Nanang Hape as acting coach. Rusdi Rukmarata as the director. We give our biggest gratitude for Sister Francesco Marianti Oesu. And also we would like to thank the mentors, committee, and crew who had already given their hard work to make this performance succeed. And we also would like to thank our sponsors, PT Kalbe, Dunamis Organization Services, Bank Sentral Asia, and Kompas TV as our media partner. And last but not least, we like to thank all of the audiences here for your presence here today so that Smash the Musical could be performed well. And I'm Cristela Fenishanti. Good night and see you on the next performance.